for single machine total completion time. So if we have three jobs, job 1, job 2 and job 3, as you could see here, and the processing time for job 1 is 7 hours, 2 hours for job 2, 5 hours for job 3. Total completion time. Completion time is literally, for example, CJ. If we start with job 1, so it needs 7 hours of machining. So this scale here, it means 0 hour of machining, 1 hour of machining, 2 hours, all the way to 14. Why 14? Because we have 9 plus 5 equals 14. So we start here. If we start with job 1, so it takes us to 7. Job 2, it takes us to 9. That needs 9 hours and 14. So all of them, they finish at 14. But the summation of the completion time for job 2 would be not 2, it would be 9. So you add 7 plus 9 for this scale plus 5, so it will come up to 14. If we do it 1, 3, 2 in this sequence, so we add 7 plus 12 plus 2 is equal to 14, or 33. 7 plus 12 plus 14 equal to 33. If we try this one, job 2, it require 2 hours, so it will be 2, and 7, 9, and so the best one is 23. So this one, it finish at 2, this one, it finish at 9, and this one, it finish at 14. So 14 plus 9, okay, so 14 plus 9 plus 2 is equal to 25. Let's try this one. So it's like 2, 3 will finish at 7, so 9 plus 14 is equal to 23. So the best optimal sequence in total completion time for scheduling is to start with a job with the least processing time and place a job in an increasing order with respect to their processing time.